The menu bar provides access to the full range of features available in Crystal Reports for Enterprise. Note that any available keyboard shortcuts are also displayed in the menus. The standard toolbars allow you to access common features such as Open, Save, Print, Export, Cut, Paste, and Undo. The Insert tab allows you to insert objects into your report, such as text, groups, sections, calculations, pictures, or charts. The Format tab provides access to functions for formatting the selected field, such as adjusting the font size, font color, background color, and text alignment. It also allows you to apply conditional formatting, such as highlighting values above or below a specific threshold. When you click the Conditional Formatting button, the formatting box opens. Here you define the conditions under which you want conditional formatting to appear. In the Formatting Settings area, you specify the formatting you want to appear when the condition is met, such as changing the font color or font style. The Data tab provides features to help you work with data, such as editing queries, creating groups and sorts, applying interactive filters to restrict the data displayed in the report, and creating formulas to add custom calculations to your report. When you click the Formulas button, the Formula Workshop opens. Formulas allow you to create custom calculations for use in your report. The main working area in Crystal Reports for Enterprise is called the Report Design Canvas, and it's divided into a Structure tab and a Page tab. On the Structure tab, you create the overall report structure by placing items in the various sections of the report. You can also apply any desired sorting, grouping, or totaling. Here you work with placeholders for the data, not the data itself. The Page tab displays the report data based on the structure you created in the Structure tab. Here you can evaluate the formatting and layout of your report design, and you can edit and polish the report for distribution. By default, a Crystal report is divided into 5 different sections, which reflect the different parts of the report. Additional sections are added if you apply grouping to the report, for example, grouping data by country or region. The report header section is used to display the report title, along with any other information you want to appear at the beginning of the report, such as charts or pictures. The page header is used for information you want to appear at the top of each page of the report, such as column names. The body section is used for the main body of the report and contains most of the report data. On the Page tab, the information included in this section is repeated once for every record. For example, if you include the Cost field in the Structure tab, the cost information for each record in the data source appears on the Page tab. The Report Footer section is used for information you want to appear at the end of the report, such as grand totals. The Page Footer section is used for information you want to appear at the end of each page of the report. On the left side of the interface are icons you can click to open various side panels. The icons that appear at any given time depend on the contents of the report and on whether you are viewing the Structure tab or the Page tab. The Data Explorer panel allows you to insert, modify, or delete objects for your report. The panel shows any data source connections and groups objects into categories. Categories include result objects, formulas, parameters, running totals, and predefined objects. To insert objects in the report, you select them in the Data Explorer and drag them to the desired section of the report. When you click the Edit Data Sources link, the Query panel opens. In the Query panel, you select the objects you're interested in from the data source and drag them to the Result Objects pane. In the Query Filters pane, you can apply filters to restrict the data returned by your report. The Outline panel shows the content of the report in a tree view, with a separate node for each report section, and a subnode for each object in each section. You can use the Outline panel to navigate the report, as well as to select, format, and delete objects. The Group Tree panel allows you to navigate the groups and subgroups in the report. This panel is only available from the Page tab. The Prompts panel allows you to interactively filter the report data by changing prompt values. In this example, you can enter the name of the person whose results you want to see. The Prompts panel is available only from the Page tab and only appears if the report contains at least one prompt. The Triggered Alerts panel shows any alerts that have been added to the report. Alerts can be triggered to appear when certain conditions are met, such as sales revenue results exceeding a specified value. The Triggered Alerts panel is only available from the Page tab and only appears if the report contains at least one triggered alert. The Search panel allows you to search the report for instances of any value or keyword. The search panel is only available from the Page tab. You've now reviewed the interface elements of SAP Crystal Reports for Enterprise. For more SAP Business Intelligence tutorials, visit sap.com/learnbi.